let's write down some pseudocode for a sequential BFS algorithm. This algorithm would take as input a graph G, represented by its vertices and edges, as well as a source vertex S. What it will produce is a map of distances D, where D of a vertex X is the distance from S to X. Now, initially, we don't know any of the distances. So, we'll initialize D to be infinity for all vertices except S. S is just zero edges away from itself. Notice that according to this initialization convention, if there is no path from S to X, then we'll get an infinity at D of X. Now, the algorithm will also maintain a QF of unvisited vertices. Initially, F just contains the source S. Now, as long as F is non-empty, the algorithm does the following. It first extracts an unvisited vertex V. It then loops over all of V's neighbors. Let's call a given neighbor W. If W does not have a distance yet, meaning its distance is set to infinity, then we'll update its distance to be the distance of V plus 1, since W is just one edge away from V. In addition, if it didn't have a distance yet, then it wasn't visited. Therefore, we should throw W into the visited queue. In this example, I've given this vertex a label of A, and I've thrown it into F. Now let's consider the next neighbor of the current vertex V. It's also unvisited. So we'd repeat this process of updating its distance and adding it to F. Now would be a good time for you to pause and continue to trace the algorithm to see how it works and convince yourself that it's correct. Now, what is the cost of this algorithm? Since you traced its execution, as I suggested, then you observe that it only inserts a vertex into F if it has not yet been visited. Therefore, the number of iterations of the while loop shouldn't be more than the number of vertices, or the size of V. And since each vertex appears in F at most once, we'll visit each edge at most once if the graph is directed, or twice if the graph is undirected. That means that the body of the innermost for loop will be executed a total number of times that is at most big O of the number of edges. In other words, the total cost of the algorithm is big O of the size of V plus the size of E. Again, if you trace through the algorithm yourself on a sample graph, you'll see how this happens.